just who is hoodwinking who? There's no doubt COVID-19 has caused great uncertainty in the world, but does that mean we should ignore the scientists, doctors and even politicians who are working to figure out ways to beat the virus? Well, yes, if you believe an increasing number of increasingly angry people who are convinced coronavirus is nothing more than a sinister plot to control their lives. But what do these conspiracy theorists know that we don't? And why are so many people listening to them?
That there's two things that are important in life, it's truth and it's freedom.
Shocking and horrific Australian government fascist lockdown.
COVID-19 has created a perfect storm for conspiracy theorists.
It's all a mind game.
Around the world, we're seeing them become more vocal and more extreme.
What if all you ever knew was a lie?
Believing that much of what they're being told by the authorities, by the scientific and medical world, by the media, is a big fat lie.
We want information and we want the truth. The truth doesn't change.
Why have we seen this uprising, do you think? People who may never have decided to go public with their views are doing that. Why is that?
Because some things just don't make sense with this. Some things just don't add up.
The theories are as numerous as they are nonsensical.
There's your 5G policy.
From 5G towers and vaccines spreading coronavirus to suspicions the virus was unleashed deliberately by Bill Gates, or that a cabal of elites are intent on taking over the world. For most of us, they're ideas that are simply unbelievable.
Because there are ulterior motives.
Absolutely.
But to those leading the charge, we're the crazy ones if we don't start paying attention.
It's the level of lies I believe we're being told. Just seeing the way that this thing has unfolded and the motives of the government and what they're telling everyone to do, it seems more about control than preventing the spread of a virus.
Let's go, come on, let's go, come on, let's go.
37-year-old Thanos Panayiotis is an ordinary bloke from the burbs of Melbourne.
Do you feel like a rebel?
A newcomer to the world of total distrust.
We are here to ask questions and have them answered because things don't make sense.
At a protest a month ago, he took centre stage before being arrested. A dramatic introduction to his new role as a leader of the anti-lockdown movement.
I'm just some dude from Epping, to be honest.
So, what happened? How did you find yourself in this position?
When I felt that what's going on wasn't totally above board, where I believed the world is moving towards, I became concerned.
For what?
Look, I've always known and believed there are certain controlling interests in the world that are looking towards a one-world government, one-world currency, and that's a good thing as long as the people at the top have the people's best interests in mind. Because if they don't have the common man's interests in mind, then that's a very dangerous thing.
Just 2 months ago, Fennis gave up his job training security guards to set up an online group that now has 60,000 members.
Hey guys, how you going?
And he speaks to them from his lounge room about his fears for the world.
We're the people, mate. If we don't want the vaccine, we're the people, not you. You don't make the decisions for us.
I was overwhelmed by the amount of people that were in sync with what I was saying.
You see this thing here? This thing here is called a television. Tell-a-vision.
Believing mainstream media is part of the great deception, Fennis encouraged his supporters to make a show-stopping statement.
No longer will we be programmed.
He showed them how.
Tell-a-vision.
Tells us what to do. It's a television.
And many followed.
What that was a protest against the overwhelming lies that the media has been pouring.
Well, it won't light, but you get the picture.
A protest against mainstream media.
Yeah.
And here we are.
Yeah, I know.
Why?
I said to myself, look, at the end of the day, if the media want to paint you as something, they're going to paint you as it anyway. So you might as well at least have a voice and just come on and just be you.
We all know that a war is going on right now, and it's not just a COVID biological war. It's a war about ownership over your body and your mind.
Whenever there's an event, a global event or even a local event, that makes people feel that they have lost control over their lives or their future, that is when conspiracy theories emerge. Pandemics have been giving rise to conspiracy theories for centuries.
Professor Stefan Lewandowski is a cognitive scientist. He studies the way people think and why they engage in conspiracy theories.
For some people, not everybody, but for some people, conspiracy theories become very attractive because they're offering psychological comfort, ironically. If you can assume that there is a handful of really bad people out there who are conspiring to do these terrible things, that provides you with comfort because, in principle at least, it would be controllable.
So it can't have happened unless somebody or something bad was behind it.
Basically, some people find it much easier to explain big traumatic events by postulating a big, really evil cause for that.
This, to me, is the life. Is that... is this how you would like it to be?
Barefoot, hearing the ocean, having a surf. I mean, this is what it's about. And it doesn't mean we can't be serious at times. I've been known to be serious occasionally.
And complicated.
Usually with a suit on.
For a long time now, celebrity chef Pete Evans has straddled two very different worlds.
G'day everyone, afternoon update. We have some new podcasts for you.
To the more than 1.5 million people who follow him on social media, he's Paleo Pete.
And you just replace the buns with mushrooms.
Promoting a diet of low carbs.
What's the breath work called?
Served with a side dish of what he calls expanded consciousness with a dollop of conspiracy. Are you a skeptic?
It's a good question. Am I a skeptic? Because I have a very healthy skepticism about everything.
Or are you deeply suspicious?
Ooh, that's a good one too.
I am skeptical, and I also am suspicious because history has shown us that, I mean, even science, and you know this as a fact, science has been bought by vested interests in so many different fields over the years.
Pete has attracted plenty of suspicion himself, with controversial views on everything from sunscreens to dietary advice.
To immerse yourself in a healing modality or healing tool.
Most recently, he copped a large fine for spruiking a $15,000 biocharger lamp.
It's programmed with about 1,000 different recipes. There's a couple on there for Wuhan coronavirus.
Which he claimed could help those with COVID-19.
It's on my website if anyone's interested.
His social media pages have also given exposure to some of the more bizarre theories surrounding the virus. You posted, for example, a shot of Bill Gates.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, do you think he is part of a conspiracy?
I don't know. And I don't know.
You put that up on your Facebook, yeah, for example. And why do you do that?
Because
if you don't buy into it a bit?
Because what Bill is suggesting, and every single interview that he has done recently, is suggesting that the world will not become safe until every single person on the planet has been vaccinated for this.
But what makes you think he can force that, even if he thought that?
Because he seems to be having a lot of influence with certain areas.
Just like you, Pete.
I don't have the ability to put something into your body. So the comparison between me...
I'm not sure Bill Gates can put it into your body either, just quietly.
I don't know. Is the World Health Organization the one that does that? Is it the governments? Is it... Could be a great story for you to look at.
Coming up...
We're just pawns in a big game.
Do I believe the virus is real? No, I don't.
Containing the outbreak...
Is it frustrating?
It's
getting repetitive.
Of conspiracy theories.
Where my empathy starts is when people then become entrepreneurs.
And why the loudest voice is worried.
If I disappear or have a frickin' weird accident, it wasn't an accident, okay?
That's next on 60 Minutes. Pete Evans is in a place where he feels most at home. In the surf, on the beach, under the sun. Enjoying a newfound freedom and feeling ever more empowered to explore the world away from what he calls the mainstream narrative.
My intention is to inhabit a place of everything. So nothing is closed off, you know? And to be in that space, it means you're allowed to ask questions from all sides.
Well, maybe I should ask you this. You believe the virus exists.
I believe it does. From all accounts, it seems to be that that exists, yes.
I ask you that because that's one of the many things that are said in this alternative space, that the virus simply doesn't exist.
Yeah.
So you accept that the COVID-19 virus exists?
To the best of my knowledge, at this particular point in time, all the evidence proves or shows at this point in time that the COVID-19 virus exists.
It's a real thing.
Yeah.
And if there was a vaccine...
Correct.
..would you take it?
That's an interesting question. No.
Does that make you an anti-vaxxer?
No, not at all. I'm a big proponent of vaccines. There are very important vaccines out there in the community, to the best of my knowledge.
Just that this vaccine is a problem for you if it should come about.
Well, there's therein lies the detail to the question. If it comes about, and if it is proved to be 100% safe for every single man, woman and child on the face of the planet. Now, if somebody can say and prove that it is completely safe, then I might consider it.
For protest leader Fenis Panayiotis, the seeds of doubt about coronavirus and the true world order were sown when he was 12 years old, when he made the curious promise to his father that he'd never allow himself to be microchipped.
I remember I came into the house and my dad sat me down and he said, there's going to be a day in the future that you're going to get told to put a microchip in you. He goes, just listen to my words. When that day comes, don't you dare put that thing in your body.
Do you know where your father got that idea from?
I'm quite sure that it was from something called the Prophecy of St. John that he'd read.
As far-fetched as it might sound, Fenis is convinced that day may soon be upon us all. When countries went into lockdown as the virus was sweeping the world, infecting more than 6 million people, Fenis decided the numbers just didn't add up.
In my opinion, do I believe the virus is real? No, I don't.
There's no COVID-19
I believe there's probably a flu going around getting people sick, but I believe the motives of the world at the moment doesn't make sense at all.
What would it take to change your mind about the contagious nature of this virus?
See it be contagious.
Did you see those pictures in Italy? Have you seen those pictures in New York? Does that not tell you, wow, this is a contagious virus?
Yeah, but there's media manipulation.
And you know what we are? We're just pawns in a big game.
I think particularly with the lockdown, a lot of people have lost their usual routine, their usual structures, their usual support systems. And then when people are more isolated, they've got a bit more time to think, they've got a bit more time to worry. That also builds anxiety and leaves people more vulnerable to these dangerous ideas being flouted out there.
Dr. Danielle McMullen is president of the New South Wales branch of the Australian Medical Association.
Hi, so you're here for your flu vaccine today?
Containing the outbreak of conspiracy theories has become another part of her job, particularly during COVID-19 times. Is it frustrating?
It's getting repetitive. So it is frustrating that people think that we're all out to get you and it's all one big lie, because the health system, nor the healthcare workers working within it, nor the governments in charge of it have anything to gain from this pandemic.
So you obviously don't think Bill Gates is behind all this?
I do not think Bill Gates is behind coronavirus, and I also don't think he would have anything to gain through creating coronavirus, nor can we put microchips into people through vaccinations. Let's get that clear.
There's no doubt the spread of coronavirus has seen an amplification of fears on so many fronts, and with it, a sense of powerlessness and loss of control that Pete Evans identifies with.
You've seen the stories of people that haven't been able to, you know, connect. You know, I shared that I visited my mum through this whole thing, and I love you, Mum, and she probably wouldn't like me saying it, but, you know, she said, oh, I don't know what to believe. And I asked her, I said, Mum, can I give you a hug? And can your granddaughters give you a hug? And that action alone, fuck. That is what being human is about. And if I have to live in a society where I can't hug my mum because I've been told it's unsafe, she was allowed to make the decision whether we hugged her or not. I said, this is your decision, Mum, but we're here for you. And she fucking needed it. She needed that. And I needed it, and my kids needed it. You know, and... oh.
It's that sense of vulnerability that scientist Professor Stefan Lewandowski sees as giving rise to conspiratorial thinking. Fringe ideas of a small percentage of people given power by social media.
Unlike real life, I can go onto social media and it doesn't matter how absurd a belief I hold, I will find a community of like-minded people. I can think the earth is flat. Guess what? I go on Facebook and out of the billions of Facebook users, a few hundred others will believe what I believe. Now, in real life, you can't do that because there's so few of them that you'll never find them. But on social media, you can. Now, that is not a trivial result, because what that does is to reinforce people's belief and makes them more resistant to persuasion.
There's usually some unkind words said about conspiracy theorists. Should we be a bit more gentle about that?
I totally understand why some people would be drawn to a conspiracy theory because it offers comfort. Now, where my empathy stops is when people then become entrepreneurs and they're pushing these theories in order to attract attention or for political benefit or sometimes even for monetary benefit. That is where my sympathy stops very abruptly and clearly, because I know what adverse consequences conspiracy theories can have for society.
All I'm saying is sometimes what we've learned isn't always the truth. What I speak may not always be the truth, but at this particular point in time, this is to my best of my knowledge, and it may be wrong, or maybe there's a little bit of truth into it. But for me, it's my truth.
They make unlikely kindred spirits, but both Pete Evans and Fenis Panayiotis not only share a gut feeling about the world around us, they both say they are prepared to be wrong.
It's a strange place to be now, isn't it, for you?
Look, at the end of the day, what I'm doing at the moment can't be explained by the rationale of a person who doesn't see that there's anything going on that's sinister. I'm doing this because I'm concerned about the safety of everybody. I've put my whole life on the line for this.
And it stinks of deceit and deception.
I hope I'm wrong. I hope I'm wrong about all this stuff.
What would it take to show you that you are wrong?
We're not tracked and, you know, we're not... we don't become a one-world government. No more social distancing. Life goes back to normal.
For Pete Evans, keeping a skeptical eye on what we're being told is as healthy for us as a good diet and regular exercise, a message he's determined to continue to spread, whatever the personal cost. Have you been hurt?
Yeah, I've been hurt.
Because of the choices you've made, the things you've said.
Yeah, the things...
The judgments that have been made.
Yeah, I've taken a few on the chin, right? And, you know, and sometimes I ask, well, what is this journey that I'm on? I never wanted to be famous or that, you know, and I could very easily disappear. I could very easily disappear, you know. Some people would like me to disappear, no doubt, and I'll just make this one statement. If I disappear or have a frickin' weird accident, it wasn't an accident, okay? You know, and that's probably the most conspiratorial thing that I will say, that I am of what I believe, complete sound mind and body and spirit.
That says to me you don't always feel safe.
There's been too many coincidences out there in the world for people that have questioned certain things. Sometimes those people don't last very long, and that could just be a coincidence.
Or you think that could be you?
I don't know.
Hello, I'm Liz Hayes. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.